Good morning, everyone, and welcome to St. Marcelline on this beautiful day. There's that little orange thing in the sky this morning that we haven't seen for some time. I think it's called the sun or something. Absolutely beautiful out today, so we thank God for a beautiful day to celebrate the Holy Eucharist together as a parish family. Our presider this morning is Father Tony Beery, and our deacon is Don Myers. And today we celebrate the 24th Sunday in Ordinary Time. And now, as a loving community welcoming all to this liturgy, we now ask you to please stand and offer a greeting to those around you.
Sins as we forgive, you taught us, Lord, to pray, but you alone can grant us grace to live the words we say. How can your pardon reach and bless the
the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My sisters and brothers in Christ, we gather each weekend with family, friends, and neighbors to worship God, a God of mercy, a God of healing, a God always willing to forgive. We are called to do the same. We are called to reconcile with our family member, our friend, our neighbor, just as God reconciles with us when we turn away. May the nourishment we receive at the Lord's table strengthen us as we face the challenge of forgiving each other. And now, my brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And now, let us offer our ancient hymn of praise. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated in the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Wrath and anger are hateful things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance, for he remembers their sins in detail. Forgive your neighbor's injustice. Then, when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. Could anyone nourish anger against another and expect healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon for his own sins? If one who is but flesh cherishes wrath, who will forgive his sins? Remember your last days. Set enmity aside. Remember death and decay, and cease from sin. Think of the commandments. Hate not your neighbor. Remember the Most High's covenant, and overlook faults. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Slow to
anger, rich in kindness. The Lord is kind and merciful. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my being, bless God's name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, forget not all God's blessings. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Slow to anger, rich in kindness. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, full of kindness. God is good to all creation, full of compassion. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Slow to anger, rich in kindness. The Lord is kind and merciful. The goodness of God is from age to age, blessing those who choose to love, and justice toward God's children on all who keep the covenant. The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Slow to anger, rich in kindness. The Lord is kind and merciful.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord. And if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or we die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. The word of the Lord.
give you a new commandment, says the Lord. Love one another as I have loved you.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Peter approached Jesus and asked him, Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive? As many as seven times? Jesus answered, I say to you, not seven times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full. Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to choke him, demanding, pay back what you owe. Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, be patient with me, and I will pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, you wicked servant, I forgave you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you? Then in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you unless each of you forgives your brother from your heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be Jesus Christ, now and forever. There are many parables about forgiveness written in the pages of the Gospel, including the very popular one about the prodigal son and the father who forgives him and accepts him and does not reject him. These parables show how much importance Christ attaches to mutual forgiveness. In another parable, Jesus calls the servant wicked not because he squandered money, but because he did not forgive a small debt from his fellow servant, while his master forgave him a debt that is incomparable greater. In the letter of St. James, we read that God has prepared an inexorable judgment for him who does not do mercy, because if we do not forgive people, our Father will not forgive us our sins. Saint Augustine writes, "Yes, then if you have sins, brothers, let us forgive those who ask for it. Let us not keep hostility towards anyone in our hearts, because when a lot of hatred accumulates in the heart breaks down." In the first letter of Saint Peter, we read, "Above all, have persistent love for one another, for love covers many sins." The connection of God's forgiveness with one another's forgiveness has a special place in the Our Father, our daily prayer, where we pray, "Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us." Once upon a time, to the confessional of St. John Bosco, while he was hearing confessions, a young man came and said, "I know that you have to forgive resentment and guilt of various people. I understand that you cannot wish anyone badly, that you cannot be angry. But I cannot understand my father. I cannot forgive him in any way, because my father is an animal and not a human. It is the meanest individual in the world, and I cannot forgive him." John Bosco replied, "My son, I understand that you have a great grudge against your father, but you cannot receive absolution now, but only in a year. During this time, you will be praying Our Father daily, but in a slightly different form. Instead of the words, 'Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us,' you will say, 'Forgive me my sins, because I do not want to forgive my father's sins.'" After 3 days, the young man came to St. John Bosco and said, "Father, who could stay longer and say such a terrible prayer? How can I pray that God will not forgive me for my sins? I cannot pray like that. I already understood everything. I know that I have to forgive, and that is why I forgive my father. I throw all my grievances out of my heart, because I want God to forgive me all my sins." My dear friends, sisters and brothers in Christ, dear parishioners, each of us knows that the deepest touch of God's love, which is merciful forgiving, can be experienced during confession, sacrament of reconciliation. The world we live in remains nice and pleasant to us. On the one hand, we have so many opportunities to feel joy, give ourselves pleasure, and feel happiness, such as cinema, swimming pool, excursions, etc. Although this is not true during a pandemic. On the other hand, this world is extremely cruel and hard for us, judging us immediately. Due to such difficulties, many people can become hurt and angry. Angry or hurt. We have all heard today the dialogue between Jesus and Saint Peter about forgiveness and its quantity, in which Jesus said, up to 77 times. What exactly is this forgiveness? Forgiveness is the most difficult love, said Albert Schweitzer. The act of forgiveness refers to the wrong that another has done to us, more or less consciously. We all experience injustice and humiliation from time to time. Some have to endure daily suffering, not only when they are innocently imprisoned, but also in the workplace or in the family circle. No one can hurt us like the ones we love. The only pain that pierces more than steel is hostility that comes from loved ones, say the Arabs. My dear friends, forgiveness is about giving up revenge and still wishing the other the best. The Christian tradition shows us touching testimonies of such attitudes. We know not only the example of the first martyr, Saint Stephen, who prayed for those who stoned him. In 1994, for example, a Trappist named Christian was murdered along with other confreres in a monastery in Algeria, in an area at risk of war. Christian left a farewell letter, a spiritual testament to his family. In this testament, Christian thanks everyone he has met in his life and says, literally, all of you, my friends from yesterday and today, are involved in this thank you. And you too, my friend of the last hour, deserve my thanks. Yes, also you, who did not know what you were doing, are included in my thanks. I can see you clearly in front of me and tell you thank you. And for now, because I hope to see you, happy as a thief on the cross, someday
in heaven.
We may think that this is an ideal that can be admired but not imitated, and that has little to do with our daily lives. But can a mother ever forgive her child's murderer? Can we forgive someone who ridiculed us completely in front of others? Can we forgive someone who has taken away our freedom or dignity? Can we forgive someone who lied to us and cheated or destroyed something that is very valuable to us? These are some of the situations in life in which it is appropriate to ask yourself forgiveness. My dear friends, sisters and brothers in Christ, dear parishioners, what does forgiveness mean? What does it mean when I say to someone, I forgive you? It is obvious that I react to evil that someone has done to me. Of course, I do not have to forget injustice, but I give up my revenge and wish the other person anyway. The secret is not to identify the opponent with his act. Therefore, we condemn evil, not the man who made it. For every human being, despite all his mistakes, is the image of God. Nobody is completely broken. The light of good shines in every person. Forgiveness includes an intense love for another person. Writer Werner Berggren once said that love protects itself through fidelity and is fulfilled in forgiveness. To forgive means to be firmly convinced that behind all evil there is a wounded and transformable human being. It means believing in the possibility of further development of the other person. Through forgiveness, we try to overcome evil with an abundance of good. It is a priceless gift of love, always an undeserved gift. This means that the one who forgives does not force the opponent to do anything, not even to regret what he has done. In conclusion, let us end our reflection with a wise proverb. Do you want to be happy for a moment? Take your revenge. Do you want to be happy always? Forgive. Let us profess now our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. And rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated on the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. First one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. As we sang in our psalm today, the Lord is kind and merciful, and so we offer our petitions to God, seeking a response of kindness and mercy.
For the church, that we may be a model of forgiveness and mercy in a world that shouts out for vengeance and retribution, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that they may temper justice with mercy as they enact and enforce the laws of their land, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our grandparents, living and deceased, in thanksgiving for all the blessings we have received from them, and for the prominent roles they have played in many of our lives, as we celebrate Grandparents' Day, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our young people that are receiving their confirmation this afternoon, let the power of the Holy Spirit descend upon them and instill in them the power of love and service, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. For those who are homebound in our parish family, those written in our bulletin, and those who need our immediate prayers, especially Caroline Bezik, we pray. For all those who are sick, for all who suffer from COVID-19, and for all who have died, especially Geraldine Wojny, we pray. May we remember the intentions written in our Book of the Faithful and those for whom this Mass is being offered, especially Gregory Concos, Muriel Hardgrave, Derek Winker, we pray. And now, in the silence of our hearts, we offer our own petition. We pray. Merciful God, as sinful people turn to you as the ultimate source of justice and mercy, hear our cries and listen to the prayers we make in the name of your Son and our Savior. We ask this through Christ, our Lord.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Marcelline, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be cursed to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Thanking God for our life, our family, our faith, as one family of Saint Marcelline Parish, let us pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy, but only say the word.
Strength.
Let's pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects, and not our own desires, may always prevail in us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The next opportunity for the Sacrament of Reconciliation is on Saturday, October 12th at 4 p.m. Please see our website to register. Also, save the date for Father Tony's Mass of Installation will take place on Saturday, October 24th at 5 p.m. As the fifth pastor of St. Marcelline, this is a time to celebrate and come together and to pray for his ministry amongst us. For those needing service hours for our faith formation programs or for high school, are asked to call Howard at the Administration Center. We warmly wish and acknowledge all our grandparents and great-grandparents on this Grandparents Day weekend. Thank you for all you have done to form and to shape our lives. Just a couple of reminders regarding signing up online. If you intend on not attending, something changed during the week or on the weekend and you are not able to attend Mass and you did in fact register, we do ask you, please kindly unregister yourself and cancel that reservation to open up a spot for other people. Also, just a reminder that walk-ins, we're only allowed 10 walk-ins per Mass, and those are for people who are unable to register online, or they could call the office, but those are not for people who may have forgotten or who don't feel like registering or don't think they should need to register. We had over 40 people over our count today at Mass, which is completely unacceptable. So we have to keep a very strict count on who's in Mass, and we have to just kind of rearrange our own, how we do things. So just be careful, making sure that you do in fact register. Thank you.
When we choose to forgive, even if the offender doesn't ask for forgiveness, we stop being that wronged person. We overcome the stress and bitterness and negativity that were wrapped around us. Best of all, we open ourselves up to the Lord's healing. If you are struggling with a grudge or offense, bring it to God in prayer. Ask Him to help you release your hold on anger, even if you feel justified. Forgive the person who hurt you, even if you cannot physically reconcile with them. Let the act of forgiveness bring you peace and help you move on. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Please be seated.
Of God is